Good morning! Welcome to the weekly vlog. Guys, today's a different type of Saturday. I'm not going to the gym. I'm not going for a walk. The first thing I'm doing is going to pick up one of my friends. She's staying in a hotel in the city and I haven't seen her in nearly a year. She's from Sydney and we're going to have breakfast and I'm going to take her to the airport and I'm so excited because I love her so much. She was one of my first friends in Sydney. I'm going to pick her up now and I'm so excited. Also, how rude of me. If you are new here, hello. My name's Adele. I post 2 videos a week. This video is my weekly vlog. Hopefully you stick around to the end. If you like it, please like it. Please subscribe. Please leave a comment. And if you are a returning viewer, hello. I love you. You're amazing. Thank you for coming back. Let's go get Angie. I'm excited. Oh, guys, what a day. I'm wrecked. I had breakfast with Angie. It was so nice. We went to Top Paddock, which is one of my favorite cafes in Melbourne, and if you ever go there, always get the hot cake. It's like a ricotta hot cake with berries and it's mwah, chef's kiss. I'm puffed out because I was just running around. And then after that, came home, went and visited my papu. He is in an aged care facility. He has dementia and he's quite old and unwell. And so mum, dad and I went there. And then after that, I came home. And I don't know, it was just very sad. It's always very sad going there. Anyway, I came home and I just have been laying on the couch, but look at this. Oh wait, I've got to finish doing my washing. I unboxed my robe, which you would have already seen on TikTok and I mentioned it in last week's vlog too, but I can't wait to wear her. I'm so excited. And tonight I have ordered Uber Eats. It's currently 4:30. I ate that whole hot cake this morning and so I'm not really super hungry, but I ordered a poke bowl because I thought by the time it arrives that could be my dinner. My parents are away, they're down the beach, so I've got the house to myself. I'm so excited. And my plans tonight are doing my washing and editing the vlog and doing nothing because it's fucking freezing, but let's go put my washing on. I'm at the laundromat, guys. I've got my washing there. I'm just chucking it in the dryer quickly and I'll come back to get it later. Look who I have. Oh, Mr. Franklin, the star of the show. I love you. All right, mommy will be right back. I didn't want to leave him home by himself, so I was like, fuck it, I'll just bring him with me. I'm just going to quickly chuck the stuff in and I'll be right back and then we're going to go home and edit. What a beautiful Saturday night. I just feel like I've got my face burned off because I put wood in the fireplace. Anyway, look at what I have on, guys, my robe. I've had the night from hell because my computer for some reason is giving me, I don't know, technology errors, like where it wasn't loading the videos from my camera to my computer. Anyway, I'm gonna finish editing this vlog and hopefully I can edit it tonight because I really want to enjoy my long weekend. And I'll come see you before I say goodnight. Good night, guys.
I had quite possibly the worst sleep last night. We're going to the gym.
I'm excited.
I've had a coffee and I was going to eat breakfast because I'm actually hungry, but I have no strawberries again because I haven't done the groceries. So I might have to do a quick pit stop on the way home from the gym. But let's get ready for the gym.
It's raining. Oh, I've got to charge this camera. I just saw a gym crush. And I didn't think I was going to see him because it's literally so late. It is 9:50. And my plan was actually to write my number down on like a post-it note and just give it to him. And I didn't actually have that with me today, which is very annoying. So I think I'm just going to have to carry it with me at all times. But I'm going to come back tomorrow and I'm going to bring it with me and I'm going to give it to him. Because he came straight over, walked from the other side of the gym, was like, where have you been? I haven't seen you in the mornings. I was like, I'm struggling to get out of bed. And he's like, why, are you okay? And I was like, oh, I've just got low iron and the weather's been really cold. And he's like, oh, what's happening with that? And I said, I have to get an infusion. He's like, oh, I hope you feel better. Like, he's so sweet. Ah! Anyway, let's go eat. Oh, I need to buy strawberries. Fuck.
The vlog is finally uploaded. It's going live at 5 PM. I don't know why it took me so long this week. Anyway, I'm going to have a shower and actually get ready for the day now because it's 1 PM and I'm still in my gym clothes. And why are my pajamas out of the bed? All right, let's have a shower.
Tell me you have dirty hair without telling me.
I just curled it. And guys, I also used a tint for the first time on my cheek and on my lips. And I think I look really nice with it. Anyway, I just uploaded the vlog, and while I was editing it, I realized last week I dropped my coats off to the dry cleaner and I forgot about it. So let's go pick up the coats. Obviously I'm gonna get changed, and then we're going on a hunt for some snacks that you guys have been tagging me in, and I'm so excited, so let's do it.
I just went to the dry cleaners and it's closed because, guys, it's a public holiday weekend. Anyway, I'm now just running into Coles because I wanna get some snacks.
That was a failed mission, guys. So I went to Coles, the same Coles that is next to the dry cleaners. And after the dry cleaners was shut, I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna find this certain chocolate that I'm after, and I'll show you a photo. I was after the Curtis Stone caramel slice. That Coles didn't have it. And so I was like, fine, I'll drive to another Coles. So I drove 5 minutes to another Coles. That Coles didn't have it either. And I was like, you know what? I can't be bothered. I can't be bothered going to look for it today, but tomorrow I'm gonna try and find it tomorrow. So I'll keep you guys updated as I hunt for this chocolate. So many of you tagged me in this TikTok saying try it, try it, and I want to try it, but I just couldn't find it. Anyway, it is currently 4:10. I'm about to drop the vlog at 5 p.m. And what else am I gonna do today? Probably just chill, and I really want to watch Stranger Things, the new season, because I haven't watched that yet, and I feel like tonight would be a good time to start. What are you making? Carla's making dinner, guys.
Some pasta.
Delicious.
Made from Laura's mum's tomato sauce.
Oh, nothing beats homemade pasta sauce.
I'm just gonna pop some penne in the water.
Show us the penne.
It's gluten-free.
Perfect, perfect.
Made with corn and rice. Great taste, penne.
Beautiful. Master chef. Franklin just had his dinner. He's like, can I have some of that? Look at him, Carla.
I'm looking worse for wear because I've got that cream on my lip and my retainer on. We are going to go to bed. We had a beautiful pasta dinner with Carla and her girlfriend Mel. And then we watched Stranger Things, and it was just a nice, chill Sunday night. And you guys also left me really cute comments on the vlog, so mwah, I love you. And I also did a TikTok live, which was good. But I think tomorrow I was gonna like do nothing and chill, but I realized I have an event on Friday, and so I need to find an outfit for that. And I think we can go shopping together. All right, I'll see you in the morning.
I just woke up. I just fed Franklin. I'm gonna make a coffee. I think I'm going to quickly head to the gym and then have a shower. Look at my hair, by the way. I don't think I'm gonna wash it this morning. It actually, once I brush it, I think it will look all right. I had the best sleep. It's 9 a.m. as well. I've just started the fireplace because it kind of goes out. So to keep the fire going, you have to keep putting wood in it, obviously. And it did slightly go out. Oh, you were right, baby. Do you need to go to the toilet? Come on. I usually have my clothes in that room to dry, but I'm putting them in front of the fireplace because they literally dry within like half an hour. It's so crazy.
I went to the gym, had breakfast, just had a shower and did some makeup. I'm going to go find that chocolate today, and then we're going to go shopping. I think I'm going to go to Chadston because I really want to go to Zara, and I love going to Chadston. So I'm going to get changed and then we'll head off.
And I'm ready, guys. I haven't worn this before. It's the same jacket as the pink and black one. When I like something, I like something, okay? And they're very warm, good for Melbourne. I've just got jeans on with this knit, and that's my slipper. All right, let's head out.
I forgot to tell you guys, I saw Gym Crush. I posted a TikTok about it. I had actually the perfect opportunity. We were on the stairs. It was just us. And I really, at that moment, could have shooted my shot. And I didn't. Didn't have my little piece of paper with my number on it, because when I got there, he wasn't there. And I just had that where I usually leave my keys and stuff. And when I saw him, I didn't have that on me. And it just, yeah, I think I'm going to have to keep it in my bra. Maybe that's the plan. Anyway, I failed today. But I'm going shopping now, so hopefully I can find what I need. Hopefully I can find that chocolate. And yeah, hopefully the day goes up from here, because I had such a good moment and I fucked it. I'm at Chadston, guys. Let's go shopping. I'm actually really hungry. I got hungry on the drive here. It,
on the drive here. It's 1:30. I think I might get some sushi.
I'm going to Zara because I need an outfit for the weekend. So let's find one. Here is my outfit today. I am wearing this and I'm trying to find something for Friday night. Now, I have no idea what I want, but usually I can find something that I like in Zara, so fingers crossed. I'm trying on this in a size small and extra small. I see an outfit with like long boots. So let's put it on and then I'll show you how it looks. What was I thinking? Oh gosh. I mean, this is not me at all. And also like the cut of it and like this little tie thing, it's not a vibe. Okay, I think we need to go to Forever New. Well, that was the biggest fail ever. I did not find an outfit, but I got some sushi for lunch and I got a toy for my camera. Now I just need to find my car. Every time I come to Chadston, I lose the car. At least I'm on the right level. I just got home. My mum and dad are home. They're vacuuming. I don't know if you can hear that, but guys, I finally, hang on. I finally got one of these, guys, so I can stop holding the camera with my hand. Because ages ago, one of you said, oh, it's so wobbly, like your hand wobbles. And so I make a conscious effort not to wobble my hand. I'm gonna put this on and I can't wait. I can't wait to use it. I actually went to JB Hi-Fi and they didn't have it. Hi, Dad.
Wobbly one?
Come here. Why would I buy you this?
Because I'm really wobbly and shit on the camera.
This is for my camera.
What about my camera?
This is not for the phone. This is for my actual YouTube camera.
Oh, the camera. I haven't got a camera. It's all right.
It's Monday night, guys. We are having Japanese because Mum and Dad are back from the beach and we couldn't be bothered cooking. So we got a smaller serving because we all had sushi at about 3 o'clock. Delish. Mum's already in her PJs.
I had a good time at the beach. It was fun.
I'm glad.
Hi everyone. Made a bottle of vitamin C for tomorrow morning's breakfast.
Beautiful.
And it's going to be really nice. Just give it a shake in the morning.
We already tried it. It was delicious.
Yeah, I know it was. Little tripod.
Guys, I put on... That's better.
Yeah, but does it move? Does it shake if your hand shakes?
No, well, that's meant to stabilize it. I can't tell if you guys can see a difference between this clip and the last one, but I just put on the...
I'm cleaning the beast.
He's cleaning his juicer, but I just put on their little tripod slash grip thing. And look, the camera shot is better. I washed my hair. I've got my robe on. I'm going to post my daily vlog to TikTok now. And then I'm going to put away my clothes. Look how many clothes I have that are all dried and ready to be put away. And then I'm going to go to bed because I need to wake up early tomorrow. I have a day full of meetings and I cannot fuck around in the morning. And I also have to have two very hard conversations and I'm like so nervous about it. I'll tell you more once it's all settled. Good night from us, guys. We're going to bed. Franklin's gonna go in his little crate. Can Mummy have a kiss? What are you doing? Good night, guys. Guys, it's 7 a.m. I slept in. My alarm even went off and then I snoozed it. And I was like, oh, just close my eyes for 5 minutes. Anyway, probably won't see Jim crash because it's late. It's later. Although if he did have the day off work, maybe he could be here now. But anyway, I'll see you after the gym. Workout is done and now I am going to go home and get ready. I have 5 meetings today. So there'll be makeup and a cute work from home fit check. But... I met one of you at the gym and it was so cute. And no, I didn't see Gym Crush. Anyway, let's go home, eat that gross breakfast. I'm officially off it. I've got to finish those strawberries though. And then tomorrow I think I'm going to make oats. I was waiting for this. I'm ready for the day. That's my ring light. I'm working from home, guys. I'm going to get ready for work and then I've got a meeting at 10 a.m. I've got a meeting at 11, at 12, at 1:30. At 2:30, at 4:30. Today's fucked. Today's gonna be fucked. I don't know how much I'm gonna be able to vlog, but I will try. I also need to go to the post office because a really exciting delivery is there. And I can't wait to show you. All right, I will see you guys later.
I've got another meeting in 10 minutes. I just had another job interview. I've had back-to-back meetings. I haven't eaten lunch. I'm about to like... But I got a PR. I got a PR package, so let's go open it. I got PR from Doritos and Reach Out. They are partnering up with mental health, which is something I'm passionate about. And so I said yes to receiving the PR. I love this. That's really cool, guys. So the Dorito packets have Be Bold, and then it's got Reach Out's details on the back. There's more behind I'm Fine, Be Bold and Reach Out. And it says 1 in 4 young people struggle with their mental health. 70% of those who need help don't get any. Doritos has partnered with Reach Out to help change this after a lot of us are feeling the crunch. One of the most powerful and simple steps young people can take to improve their mental health is to check in with themselves. Aww, that's so cool. So this is a limited edition flavor. Bold barbecue. How cool is that? Wasted no time. It's 5:03. I'm going to get a pedicure at 5:15. I've also had one of the hard conversations that I had to add, that I had to have. I'll give you an update at the end of the vlog, and I'm about to have the other hard conversation. Today has been, my stomach has been in knots. Also, I'm meant to be stabilizing with this grip, and I have just been so wobbly. I'm sorry. I just had my pedi. They did it so efficiently. The place shut at 6. Got my little yellow thongs on.
Good evening.
Do you like my pedi? Do you like my pedi? And look, a little Franklin.
I would never walk out of a salon with them on.
All right, Mr. Judgmental.
Oh, oh.
Don't lick my toes.
Matches your jumper.
I know. The yellow is a vibe. Bedtime now, guys. I just finished the Ask Me Anything. It's weird. The public holiday has like rattled me. It feels like it's a Wednesday. Update. I had both conversations. The first one went how I expected it to go. The second one didn't go how I expected it to go, but I will give you guys an update by the end of the week. Anyway, I'm gonna have a shower and get into bed. I'm fucking going to the gym in the morning. Rise and shine. Rise and shine. It's 5 a.m. She woke up. She woke up at 5 a.m. Guys, let's manifest to see Gym Crush. I finished my workout. I did see Gym Crush. When I walked in, he was like on the floor. And I walked in and he put his hand out to like high five me. I was like, oh, okay, like we're mates. He's friend zoned me. And then I went and started working out, and I went to go get my headphones from my jacket pocket, and he was leaving, and I was like, oh, are you heading off? He goes, yeah. He goes, I've got to start work at 8, and it was like 6 a.m. and I'm like, geez, you've got like a lot of time to kill. He goes, yeah, I'm gonna go to my brother's and then just like chill there, wait for him to wake up. I was like, where does your brother live? Adele, why did you ask that? And he goes, oh, blah blah blah, and I was like, fuck. Why did I ask that? I'm cooked. I have no chill. I have no game. I have no charm. And then he goes, well, today's Wednesday. You have your iron infusion. Are you working? I was like, he remembered. He fucking remembered. I was like, no, I'm working half a day, because I'm working half a day. He goes, oh, I hope it goes well. He's like, have a good day. I was like, you too. And then he left. Where does your brother live? What?
I am ready for work, guys. Here is the work from home fit check. I am just doing half a day. I told you I'm getting my infusion. And then I'm also getting my hair cut and done. After that, I'm tired after that 5 a.m. wake up. I also made oats for the first time and they were fucking disgusting. So I think I need to perfect my oats recipe before I share them online, because I ate most of them, but it just didn't really cut it. I will see you when I finish work. I'm finishing at lunchtime today. Guys, I just had an urge to check my YouTube. I was like, wait, I feel like I've hit 10K. And I hit 10,022. I just want to scream. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. If you were one of those 10,000 people that have subbed to me, thank you so much. I'm going to announce a giveaway. It will probably be up by the time you watch this. If it hasn't been up yet, it will be up. Thank you, guys. Thank you for your support. As I said, I will continue to do giveaways and show you guys how much I love you. I just had my iron infusion, guys. And then afterwards, because I deserve a treat, I picked up Oh, there's a piece of hair in my mouth. Picked up a poker. Anyway, I'm going to go in and eat now before I start feeling sick. Because last time I felt sick. But yeah, the infusion went well and I won't really know if I feel better until 2 weeks from now. So we will wait and see. But I'm done with work for the day and now I can just relax until I go to my hair appointment, which I'll take you with me too. Guys, it actually worked out so well that I took half a day off for my iron infusion because I'm about to go get my hair done and my appointment was originally at 6:30 after work and then my hairdresser rang me. She's like, can you come now? I was like, sure. So it's literally 5 o'clock on the dot and I'm going to run in there and get finally a haircut and then maybe touch up my greys. That's right. She's got grey hair. Got a haircut, guys. We also did a freshen up to get rid of some of the greys. My hairdresser said there was more greys this time. And when I walked in, I'm going to give you a bit of tea time. I walk in and there is this girl in the seat who I haven't seen in about 7 years, who was a bully to me when I was younger. It was very triggering. And I just felt so sick. It just brought up a whole heap of shit that I fucking repressed. And I was like, wow, you know what? Maybe she has changed. Maybe she's not such a nasty person. But she was really horrible to me when I was younger. Like, really horrible. Made me feel so uncomfortable. Made me so sad. Was just, like, a terrible, terrible person. And I get it. When people are younger, like, maybe they don't understand, like, the depth of, like, bullying someone or being nasty to somebody. But, yeah, it was just, like, super triggering. And then I was like, wow, time has flown. But what I want to say is if you're being bullied, it's not going to last forever. You will move forward. You will have a time in your life where that person is not in your life anymore and thank fucking goodness. You may run into them down the track, but yeah, it's just a reminder of like, wow, how far I've come. Cause maybe me now wouldn't be so upset by the things that she did to me back then, but yeah, it wasn't very nice. Anyway, I'm fidgeting cause I'm bloody distressed, but I did get a haircut and I do feel good. I was driving home and I drove past it and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna get some nuggets. I got a cheeseburger too. It's currently 8:15. I had to eat. I had to. Good morning. Two things. One, I was absolutely cooked last night. I struggled to like do the voiceover for my daily vlog on TikTok and I did not film anything on here. After I got home, I went into like a bit of a, I don't know, hangover, iron infusion hangover, but I did have a wonderful sleep. I've woken up this morning with what looks to be a flare up of my, what do you call it? Dermatitis. Anyway, it's 6 a.m. guys. I'm at the gym. I wasn't going to come. Well, it's 6:15. I'm just walking on the treadmill until like 7 a.m. because it's pouring rain. And if I don't go for a walk, I'm probably going to start a fight today. I'm not going to start a fight. I'm just going to be in a bad mood. And I would rather leave the gym feeling up here. Right now, I'm here. After the gym, I'll be here. And that will carry me through the day. Okay. I feel a bit better, but I actually feel like I'm gonna vomit. That's how I felt last time. I think I just need to take it easy. Maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I should have just slept. I think what I need to do is have some water. I walked just on the treadmill at like 5 speed, which is not that fast. My stomach just feels very unsettled. That's all. I just feel a bit off. Anyway, I sweated a tiny bit. I've got some endorphins. Now I'm gonna go home and make some food. It's still raining, so I'm glad that I walked there. I am ready and heading off to my first meeting. I'm gonna quickly run past the dry cleaners because I don't have a coat and it's at the dry cleaners and I really want my coat. So I'm gonna do that, then head into the city. I also feel terrible, pretty terrible, and I couldn't eat breakfast this morning, so I'm gonna try and force feed this muesli bar. I feel like I need to constantly throw up, and it's the iron. It's just, I think, the big influx of iron into my body. My body's like, what the hell? But my mouth is dry. Let's go get my coat. I lost the receipt from last time, but she was able to locate her receipt and then she gave them to me. I'm going to wear the dark grey one today. I don't think you guys have seen the pink one. I have this beautiful light pink coat. Oh my god, it's so, so cute. It's very old. This is the one I'm gonna wear. Otherwise, I'll freeze in the CBD and I'm gonna chuck them in the back. Let's head off to my first meeting. Oh, they feel so much better. I knew they needed a dry clean. I'm home, I just finished work at 6:15. I'm gonna edit my other YouTube video after I have dinner. I'm gonna go have dinner now, but today has been a day, guys. I'm not feeling good. I'll give you a little bit of an update later. Let's go see what's for dinner. Look at that chicken!
Chicken!
Hi, Dad.
Hello!
Got some salad.
I got my feta cheese and my olives. That's the Greek in me. I've got to have it every night because I love it. It's a Mediterranean.
What's in this?
Let's have a look. What's Mum done in here?
My fave.
Broccolini.
We love broccolini in this house.
And it's cheaper than broccoli.
Yeah, it is.
It is cheaper, guys.
That's weird. And how much was the lettuce?
The lettuce, $5 for the lettuce.
Hello. Hello. I'm going to get into bed. Today was a really long day. I was out in the city and I'm exhausted. There's a lot going on at my job, but there's a lot going on in my personal life. I've already said before, I'll tell you more once it's all settled. I'll give you an update on my work stuff tomorrow, which is fine. I actually took tomorrow off. Yeah, I just have a lot of stuff that I need to do and that stuff is taking priority, so I'm not feeling bad. Also, I felt so sick today. I probably should have not worked, but I did power through. But tomorrow I'm going to take it easy, but do what I have to do in the day. And then I've got an event tomorrow night, which I'm excited about, but I'll tell you about that tomorrow. I'm dead. So I'm going to go to sleep. Good morning. I just woke up. It's 8:30. Yay. I think I'm going to do my washing. Look at that. I've done no washing this week. And then go and walk at the gym. I'm not in the mood to lift weights. I still don't feel very well. But I'm glad I have today off. Thank goodness. Thank goodness. I just came to drop off all my washing. I've done 4 loads of washing. I did a light load, a dark load, Franklin stuff, and then all my colorful stuff because I wash all the bright pinks and oranges and stuff together. And they're all washing. I've got 45 minutes because they're all gonna take that long. So I put a little timer on. It's 10 o'clock. I'm gonna go to the gym and I'm going to do a walk because, guys, I don't think I can lift any weights. I really don't think I can. I can't. My walk is done and now I'm back at the laundromat, guys. So I'm gonna put Franklin's stuff in the dryer and I'll probably put that in for an hour. And while that's drying, I'll just like have a shower, have breakfast, and then I'll come back and get it. Okay, guys, here are the oats. I'm gonna try it. I hope that they're nice. And of course, got my cute spoon. I'm just getting ready for that event, guys. I am straightening my hair. I've done my hair and makeup. The lighting here is so, so bad. I'm sorry about that. I'm going to an event today with Emma Sleep. They are asleep. Mattress. Oh no. Just got my hair in my lip gloss. They're a sleep mattress company and they wanted to send me a mattress and I said no, I don't need one and I don't want to put like my current mattress into like the waste when my current mattress is fine. And so they invited me to their event this afternoon and I thought, you know what, I'm gonna go. I feel like it would be fun. They said they're gonna have like a sleep expert. And so far, all the events that I've gone to for brands have been incredible. So I'm hoping for the same, but I'll come back when I'm done and I'll show you my fit. Okay, here is the final fit. I so desperately wanted to wear these boots, but these jeans would not allow because they're so long. They're like so, so long. Like so long. Anyway, I'm gonna head off now. I will take the camera with me. Hopefully I can film on this camera in there so I can show you what going to an event like this is like. But I'm really excited and yeah, I can't wait. All right, I'll see you soon. I'm at the place, guys. I'm about to head in. I'm gonna grab my bag. I'm a little bit nervous. I feel like I could do a nervous poo. Wow, I definitely overshare on the internet. Anyway, I'm gonna head in and let's go. I just finished the event, guys. That was actually so sweet. We got a little goodie bag. So it was so fascinating. They had like a sleep specialist there who gave like sleeping tips and just things you can do like outside of the bedroom that can like help calm you down and like have a better night's sleep. But I think he was like the chief operations person or something, someone from Emma Mattress, that was the company that I went to today. He said, sleep is the one thing that unites us all. Every single person goes to bed at night. Every single person. That was a lot of fun and I'm so grateful. My management organized me to go to that. That was probably one of my favorite events that I've gone to. Ah, thank you guys. And as I always say, I wouldn't get opportunities like this if it wasn't for you. And I definitely think next time I need a mattress, I will get one of these because the technology that they mentioned was legit. Anyway, I will see you guys when I get home and then I'll give you some life updates.
Well, we got, this is the second time I'm having, I'm having Maccas this week. We got apple pies too, nuggies. Frank, come on, you can't have any.
We just had dinner. It was pretty good. I'm gonna jump in the shower and then wrap this vlog up. I said to you earlier, maybe at the end of last week's vlog, and even at the start of this week's vlog, that I had to have two very hard conversations. I've had those conversations and an outcome has occurred. The first conversation was at work at my 9-to-5. my boss offered me another job inside the company. A massive step up, extra money, but a lot of extra responsibility. And I declined the opportunity. I said, thank you so much. However, I don't feel like this is the right fit for me. And I just had to explain that, like, energetically, I don't feel as if I could accept that. And he thought that it was about me not believing in my ability to do it. And I was like, no, I know I could do it. I just don't want to. And the reason I'm sharing that is because I feel like for a lot of my life, I struggled to say no. And I struggled to like put up my boundaries because I was scared about how everyone else around me would react. And what I would do is sacrifice what I really wanted to keep the peace and to keep everyone around me happy instead of really listening to what I wanted. And then a few months later or years later, growing to resent my own decision and growing to resent whatever it was that I allowed. And so I've learned to be better with my boundaries, and I actually also listened to a podcast, which I'm going to link or put in the notes. It was about assertiveness, and it didn't end badly. Like, you know, we had an open discussion about it, and I think my boss also understood, and I even said to him, like, it is much better for me to be honest with you. That way you can put someone in this position that really, really wants it, and that will do good because they really want it and they're aligned with it. And I think he was a bit shocked, but by the end of it, it was fine. And he's like, so what are you doing? I said, I just want to keep doing my job, if that's okay. And we agreed. And I think that kind of even talks to that 9-to-5 video I did. I spoke about like career progression, and even in my vlog, not last week, the week before, I said I felt a bit disconnected. And I think I just have to like honor where I am. And I think it's okay to say no. And I think it's, yeah, I think you sometimes just have to back your decision making. And so I have no regrets. I actually felt like relieved after that conversation. And then the second point, I will obviously tell you guys because you deserve to know, and you were going to ask why. And I feel like I have to address it just because I want it to come from like me. This week I made the very difficult decision to end my contract with Muscle Nation, and it was not on bad terms at all. I still have a lot of wonderful things to say about them, and I've got a lot of respect for them. I love the team. I still love them. It's just that at this point in time, it wasn't an aligned decision for me, and I think I've definitely learned a lot from the experience, and I just think
there is power in knowing when something is not serving you anymore. And I think there's also power in, yeah, just really, again, backing your decision. So again, it was two very hard conversations that I had to have, but I had them and I'm feeling so much better. So much better. I can't even tell you. I had just a lot of like stress and tension in my body at the end of last week. And even that exhaustion that I was feeling, I think it was partially the iron, but I also think it was because I was worried about having these conversations. And, you know, something that I heard in that podcast that I'm going to link was you can be assertive and you can still be respectful and you can still be kind. And that's what I was in both of the conversations. And I think it doesn't have to be a bad thing when you say no to something or you change your mind about something. You're allowed to do that. And I just thought that I should firstly share that because, you know, I think as a collective, maybe we do struggle when it comes to saying no, or it comes to making decisions, or it comes to changing our mind. And then the other element is that a lot of you, and there have been a lot of you who have used my Muscle Nation code, and I still have so much gratitude and so much thanks. And that's the other reason I wanted to put it in the vlog, because if you go to use the code, it won't work. That's okay. Don't panic. I'm excited because it just means that, yeah, I have a lot more opportunities coming my way. And I always say to myself that when you let things go, you make space for other wonderful things to come into your life. And I truly, truly, truly believe that. And I back my decisions 110%. And I just wanted to give you guys that, yeah, honest update. Now I am going to wrap this vlog up. I would have posted the giveaway, I think. I would have posted how to enter the giveaway. So if you haven't watched that video, go and watch the video that's titled Giveaway, How to Enter. That's what it's going to be called. I haven't even filmed it, by the way. I'm filming this on Friday and I'll probably post the giveaway tomorrow and I'll film it tomorrow. And then I don't know when I'm going to draw the winner, but I really want you guys to win, so make sure that you enter. And again, a huge thank you for hitting 10k on YouTube. I got an email from YouTube that said congrats. I was like, oh my god, thank you. So this week has been a huge week, guys, and I'm glad that I made it to the end of it. But I am going to get into bed now because I am sleepy. She's a sleepy girl. Oh, also, I have cream on my lips again, so I'm sorry if you've seen it this whole clip. But anyway, you should be used to me showing up with literally no shame now. Anyway, guys, I love you and I hope that you have a magical week ahead. And this video is for any of you that have a hard decision to make or any of you that have to have a difficult conversation. You've got this. I promise you, you've got this and you will get through it. Trust me. All right. I love you guys. I'll see you next time and yeah, bye.